say, can you see?
Yep, well, good. Thank you, Benny. Cool, thanks, man.
Oh, P.S.
That's great.
Oh, race.
It's the penultimate game of the regular season, and it has postseason implications as the Delaware Blue Hens, 16-13 overall, 8-8 in CAA play, host the Northeastern Huskies, who come in with an 18-10 record on the year, 12-4 in conference competition here in Newark, Delaware. Good evening, everyone, and welcome inside the Bob Carpenter Center in Newark, Delaware. I'm Corey Nido, alongside Bill Harmon. And Bill, these two teams are looking to maintain their top four seeding Conference Tournament. UD leads the all-time series 29-27 and snapped a three-game skid to the Huskies thanks to that thrilling double overtime win up in Boston back on December 30th when Delaware held on to an 82-80. These two teams, totally different. We'll talk about that in just a moment. But first, let's get you tonight's starting lineups brought to you by Delaware State Education Association, DSEA. Standing strong for student success. Nominate an all-star in education by going to WDSD.com and clicking contest. First, for the visiting Huskies, it will be the Serbian native Vasa Pušica, a redshirt senior guard leading the Huskies at 17.6 points per game, along with redshirt junior Jordan Rowland out of Syracuse, New York, and Danelle Gresham averaging 10.5 points per game in the backcourt for Northeastern. The frontcourt, Bolden Brace out of Santa Barbara, California, a 6'6" junior, and a 6'10" senior, Anthony Green out of Quincy, Massachusetts, for 13th year head coach Bill Cohen. For the Delaware Blue Hens, it will be Ryan Allen, the 6'2" sophomore out of Bowie, Maryland. Darian Bryant, the redshirt senior, as well with Ithiel Horton, the 6'3" freshman, the backcourt for Delaware. In the frontcourt, it is Eric Carter and Ryan Johnson for third-year head coach, Martin Inglesby, as these two teams get ready to hit the hardwood. Our officials tonight, referee Jeff Clark, Clarence Armstrong and Nick Heater making up the three-man crew. Delaware sporting their all-black uniforms that were introduced earlier this year. Black tops, black shorts, royal blue numerals and lettering outlined in the gold for Delaware. Delaware in all caps across the chest. Last names in all caps on the back. Northeastern in its road red tops and pants with gold piping down the side. White numerals outlined in black, black nameplates across the back, and Northeastern in black script across the chest. We're almost ready for jump off, and Eric Carter against Anthony Green. Green wins it, and Northeastern will be moving right to left on the dial to start tonight's game.
A lot of misdirection by Northeastern in their man-to-man attack. They do a lot of ball screening action, a lot of dribble handoffs.
Top of the key three drained by Vasa Pušica, as we mentioned in the opening. Leading the team with 17.6 per game, gets Northeastern out to an early 3-0 lead.
Darian Bryant's got the assignment on Pušica, and it's really important that you make him a dribbler at the three. He can create, but he's much better from the standstill.
Carter with it, left baseline, being guarded by Green. Now drawing a little bit of a double team, swings it out left wing to Allen. Allen pulls up for a three, rattles in and out of the rim. It was a good look. Pušica with the rebound. Northeastern hustling right to left. Right corner three drained by Jordan Rowland. Back-to-back trays opens up the game for the Huskies.
Northeastern very dangerous in transition. They'll push the ball ahead. They'll look for threes from the line. If they don't get it, they'll run their offense. Very important. Delaware gets back and has at least five players back at all times.
Horton trying to create separation. Swings it out to the perimeter where Bryant has it right wing, gets a pick from Carter, dribbles right, now needs help, spins around, jumps it, and misses off the front of the rim, rebounded by Green. Here comes the Huskies.
Pušica is very good at handling the ball. Not your prototypical point guard, but very clever, not super quick and athletic, but has a great feel for the game.
Left wing three by Brace, too strong off the iron, rebounded by Bryant. Delaware looking for its first basket, down 6-0 early here in the first half.
Delaware's got to really run some good offense. Go back into Eric Carter. They doubled on the dribble with Gresham before off of Ryan Allen. So if he enters it and Gresham doubles, they'll be able to get a kickback shot.
Allen gives it to Bryant. Bryant top the key, dribbles left elbow, passes too wide. Off the fingertips of Ryan Johnson, goes out of bounds, so a turnover for Delaware.
It was the right play by Darian Bryant, playing that hybrid point guard, driving down the lane and kicking it to Ryan Johnson in the corner. Unfortunately, they just misconnected there. He was expecting Ryan Johnson to be in a slightly different place.
Solid crowd on hand inside the Bob tonight. These two teams looking to keep positioning in the top four of the CAA for the tournament. High low goes down low to Green. He kicks it out top of the key where a three is taken by Danelle Gresham. He misses. Horton with it, moving left to right for Delaware.
Ryan Allen at times will run the point along with Darian Bryant and Ithiel Horton. What it allows, though, when Ryan Allen's off the ball is all that creative movement he gets.
Carter down baseline, left side, finds Horton. Left wing, three, buries it, and the freshman gets the Blue Hens on the board at 6-3 Northeastern.
They helped off Horton that time with Jordan Rowland to double-team Eric Carter. Eric Carter kicks it right back out. Ithiel Horton in rhythm, rises up and makes a big three to get Delaware going.
Gresham swings it out to Brace. Head fake, gets a little bit closer right baseline, but a whistle blown. And a foul is called on Delaware's Ryan Johnson, his first personal, team's first.
Bolden Brace loves to shoot the three, but he's also very clever at using the shot fake. That's what caught Ryan Johnson on the foul.
17-10 left in the first half, but a foul called off ball against the Huskies. It was against Anthony Green, his first, team's first, so it gives Delaware the ball as Pushitsa was lining up to take a three.
Anthony Green, a big man, 6'10", 252, very physical inside. He'll work hard on Eric Carter to deny him good low post position. Eric's got to work extremely well to get in the right spot at the right time against Green.
Horton was fouled by number 12, Jordan Rowland, the redshirt junior out of Syracuse, New York, his first personal, team second, as Horton was trying to dribble drive off the left elbow.
Northeastern works very hard at denying any three-point shots. They really guard the line, so it's important that Delaware drives the ball on him with some shot fakes or gets the ball inside to Eric Carter.
Ball on the top of perimeter. Horton has it now, left wing, dribbles near the foul line, finds Bryant, who cuts in and lays it off the glass right hand for a basket.
Ithiel Horton made the play by getting into the lane. He drew the help from the weak side. Darian Bryant very intelligently cuts back door. A wonderful pass from Horton. A great job by Bryant recognizing what his defender was doing.
Delaware down by one early in the first half against Northeastern. Pushitsa, near corner three, rims in and out of the bucket, looked good. Unable to get it in, though. Bryant now has it. Cross dribbles over. Now needs some help on the right perimeter. Gives it over to Johnson. Johnson finds Allen. Allen swings it to Bryant, who's in the near right corner. He goes baseline, and the ball is tipped out of bounds. Looks like it will remain Blue Hens basketball.
Bryant being guarded by Pushitsa in the deep corner. A nice little ball fake and then tried to spin and go baseline. He was making the correct pass. It just got knocked out of bounds, but he was trying to throw it through to the deep corner.
Horton give and go three. Misses off the back of the rim, but long rebound by Bryant. He gives it to Johnson. Feeds it over to Allen. Allen being guarded. Gets a pick from Carter. Goes near the foul line. Finds Horton left wing. 20 on the shot clock. Under 15 to play here in the first. Delaware down 6-5. Carter getting double-teamed. Good ball movement around the perimeter. Now the ball is in Allen's hand, right corner. He stutter steps, baseline, needs help. 10 on the shot clock, gives it to Horton, trying to get some separation. Right wing, pulls up, and he finds the bottom of the net for another three. Horton with two threes early tonight.
Horton rejecting the ball screen up top, meaning he goes away from it. But what that did was get his defender leaning towards the screening action, allowed him to work up into his right shoulder into the shot.
Blue Hens with its first lead. Give and go down low to Green, but he's fouled. And it will be a media timeout here inside the Bob Carpenter Center. And that will allow us to have Bill Harmon give us his key players to the game as Delaware is up 8-6 over Northeastern with 15:20 left here in the first half.
What?
Oh, say, can you see 2 million bucks?
Lotto America is the new drawing game that's sweeping the nation. Get six numbers right, including the star ball, and you win. And with jackpots starting at $2 million, you win big. Lotto America from the Delaware Lottery. It's the new way to play and win the American dream.
Here's your Buick, sir.
Actually, that's my Buick.
Your Buick doesn't have a roof rack. This is my Buick.
How are we gonna fit in your mom's Buick?
Easy.
I like that new Buick.
Me too.
I was actually talking about that Buick.
I knew that.
Did you?
Buick's fresh new lineup is full of surprises. Get great deals on our expectation-shattering lineup. Pay no interest for 72 months on most Buick models.
...of its last seven, but only by 8 points or less, as Delaware looking to snap a two-game skid on its home court. Play about to resume. Pushitsa triggers it in, baseline left. Northeastern going right to left on your dial. Brace with it, loses a handle, pulls back, top of the key three, and he drains it. And that is how Northeastern has scored all of its points beyond the three-point line.
Bolden Brace has excellent range on his shot, a big-bodied shooter who finds his spots. That time he got Veretta with a little bit of space.
Carter with it. He splits two defenders, a little too strong off the glass. Ball goes out of bounds. Huskies basketball.
Well, Eric did a great job down low there of trying to find the right gap as Green and others were defending him. He just got a little quick at times. He might want to just settle it a little bit more, use a shot fake and go up. He's a very crafty interior player, though.
Pushitsa with the ball, top of the key, hands it off to Roland, who skips it over back to Pasicha, left wing. 11 on the shot clock, Delaware down 9-8, 14 and a half remaining here in the first half. Green with it, gives it into traffic to Roland, pull-up jumper, left elbow, swishes it, and Northeastern up by three, 11-8.
Roland is really clever at using screens, a really combative player who's trying to rub his defender off. Ithiel Horton did a good job of staying with him for the most part, then just got free into the mid-range going right to left.
Allen dribbles left, gives it over to Veretto. First time we've seen him tonight. Now it's into the near corner with Allen. He pulls up for a deep three, too strong, misses left of the rim. Rebounded by Bolden Brace. Here comes Northeastern. Brace trying to take it himself to the rim. He's short off the glass. Rebounded by Eric Carter, who's sixth in program history in rebounds.
Eric Carter did a great job of transitioning back on defense to get that rebound because Brace was in good position to secure his own miss.
Carter, spin around jumper right in front of the stripe where the CAA logo is on the hardwood. He finds the bottom of the net, pulls Delaware within one.
Big man coach Billy Phillips really liked that play. He got Miller pinned, Green pinned down low, and then stepped back and took a mid-range shot from about 8 feet.
Pusicha straightaway three, can't leave him open. Good ball movement. He drains it. Delaware down 14-10.
Pusicha really has a good feel for where he wants to be at all times in this offense. He's a senior, a veteran. He knows where to space up and did a good job there of just avoiding Darian Bryant and Eric Carter's high-hand contest.
Ball given to Horton, who dribbles baseline, finds Veretto, who thought about passing it to Bryant. It's punched out of bounds by Roland near sideline. Substitutions for Delaware now coming in for the Blue Hens is the junior out of Naperville, Illinois, Jacob Cushing, and redshirt junior Colin Goss coming in for Northeastern. You have Miles Franklin, a 6'4 sophomore out of Bray, California, along with senior Jeremy Miller from Milton, Massachusetts. So both teams going to its bench. 10 on the shot clock for Delaware. Goss faked a three, goes up, and he goes for the slam and then pulls up with the finger roll, lays it in nicely.
How about a great play by Colin Goss, who picked and popped, spaced away from Miller, who tried to chase him off the three because Colin can shoot it. Head fake, ball fake, drives down the lane, didn't dunk it, just laid it in. An outstanding play by Colin Goss coming off the bench and giving Delaware a lot of energy.
Foul called against Darian Bryant of Delaware, his first personal, team's third. Goss getting into the action early. Delaware down 14-12, 12-41 left here in the first half. Pasicha triggers it underneath Northeastern's hoop, and he gives it over to Gresham, who has it. Swings it over to Franklin, left wing. Pasicha with it, being guarded by Bryant, Delaware's best defensive player. Bryant trying to get some help. He swings it over now to Brace. Brace fakes a three, gets into the right side of the lane, and lays it in between Goss and Cushing.
The play was made by Pushitsa, doing a good job of reading the way Delaware is playing that weak side screening action. He makes an excellent pass to Brace, who used the ball fake to get inside and finish at the rim. Brace, known for his threes, much like Ryan Allen, really developing a good mid-range game as well as driving.
Hens down by four, under 12 minutes to go here in the first half. Goss with it, gives it to Allen, top of the key. 10 on the shot clock. He pulls up near right elbow, now gives it to Cushing. Cushing gets pickpocketed. He gets the basketball. He hits the deck, and he was surrounded by a pair of Huskies. And no signal And it looks like it will be a jump ball, a possession arrow in favor of Delaware. So the Blue Hens will get it, but two on the shot clock, and we will take a timeout as immediate timeout is called. With 11:51 left, Delaware down 16-12 on 94.7 WDSD.
The rule of three states, things that come in threes are inherently more appealing than those that don't. We couldn't agree more. Three SUVs, one GMC. Step up to GMC with up to 19% below MSRP on these select models in stock the longest when you finance through GM Financial.
The month of March is not for the weak. If you want to get to the big dance, the road starts here. Every practice, every game leads to this moment. Win or go home. The CAA tournament is coming to Charleston March 9th through 12th. 10 teams, one goal, to be crowned champion. Go to CAASports.com for more information.
Just two on the shot clock, but a whistle blown, and the ref putting both hands up, and now they'll run over to the far sideline and discuss what's going on. But, Bill, coming out of the break, we talk about it, Delaware has to protect the three-point line.
Yes, they do. Northeastern 4-for-7, they do a really nice job of spotting up. Delaware's got to be a little bit more connected and engaged defensively and extend, force them like they did to Brace to drive the ball to the basket and then rotate and give some help. Gresham doing a very nice job right now on Ryan Allen, one of the keys for Northeastern. He is not allowing Ryan to have any really good looks yet. I expect Ryan to start driving the ball once we get a deeper shot clock.
Looks like they were confirming the shot clock. Allen takes an acrobatic three. He misses. Shot clock violation. 13th-year head coach Bill Cohen liking what he sees from his Huskies team, clapping emphatically in front of his bench far sideline. Delaware down 16-12, 11:48 to go here in the first half.
Well, Ryan Allen was really smart there. He was well contested, tried to draw the foul, but just couldn't find it. Delaware going back to a little 2-3 zone here to see if they can extend and make sure they don't give up any threes.
Ball movement near corner. Brace has it, and it's stolen away by Bryant. Bryant scanning the hardwood, now finds Cushing, who gives it to Horton, right baseline. He weaves his way in and out of a handful of defenders, lays it in left side, and Ithiel Horton, who had a big game against the Huskies up in Boston, doing his part here tonight.
It was the push, sharing the ball, Cushing with a great pass down to Horton, who immediately attacked along the baseline, blew by Miller, who was just standing still and a nice finish on the weak side.
Horton had 27 points against Northeastern earlier this year, has 8 already tonight. 10 on the shot clock for Northeastern. Franklin with it, left elbow, chest pass to Bashitsa, and he drains it. He has such a pretty shot.
They don't do a whole lot against the zone. They flash a perimeter player into the middle, have a low post man. That time, Bashitsa came in from the weak side. A nice penetration there to set up the play for him. And that's the key. Miles Franklin did a nice job.
And Ithiel Horton answers with a right wing three flush. And he pulls Delaware within one, 18-17, 10.5 to go here in the first half.
Horton shot extremely well Tuesday in practice. He's very confident. He's got his conditioning. His legs are back. He really looks like he's in flow.
Horton leading all scorers with 11 so far tonight. Franklin dribble drives, finds Brace, now gives it back to Franklin. Deep three taken, and the Huskies are not missing from downtown. Back up by 4, 21-17. Is Northeastern.
Penetrating the ball into the middle of the zone and then kicking it out. It forces your defense to compact and then expand late. A nice shot there by Franklin, who's got a beautiful follow through.
Horton dribbling into traffic, loses the handle, jump ball, possession arrow in favor of Northeastern. So it will be Huskies basketball. But talking about the 3-point line, Bill, Northeastern 5 of 8 from downtown early.
Well, Martin Inglesby went to the zone to see if he could just throw him out of rhythm, and so far Northeastern's been able to adjust. At the offensive end, Delaware strategically is trying to drive the ball at all points from different areas to try to affect Northeastern's defense, who are expanding themselves out to defend a three. You drive it, you back screen it, or you can throw the ball into the post to affect it.
Eric Carter back in for Delaware. Blue Hens down 21-17, under 10 left here in the first half. Pasicha being guarded by Bryant, 10 on the shot clock. Pull-up jumper, and he drains it again. And Pasicha is just on fire right now, 10 points for the Serbian native.
He warmed up very well. He plays at a great pace. He's never out of control, knows how he wants to attack his defender, and he's got a great one on him in Darian Bryant.
Pass off the fingertips of Bryant near sideline from Allen. Looked like Bryant was going one way. Pass took him the other, trying to make an athletic grab on it. Could not. So another turnover for the Blue Hens, down by five.
Important here, we get a stop. We really need a good defensive sequence here. We're going to attack the ball screen and make sure Pozica cannot use it as effectively as he has been in the past.
Ball in the hands of Gresham, right wing, gives it over to a three taken by Jeremy Miller off the bench. And timeout taken, Delaware, as they need to try and figure out the riddle that is Northeastern's three-point shooting attack. They are now 6 of 9 from downtown, and it's almost everybody. And that's what we talked about coming into tonight's game, Bill, that not only is it Vasa Pusica, the leading scorer at 17.5 per game, but you go up and down this lineup, 7 different players average over 8 points a game. Tough to defend everybody.
And 5 players already have made a three-pointer. So it really forces your defense to expand, to try to almost play one-on-one and stay in front. If you get some screening action and you're forced to double, Northeastern will rotate the ball, and that's what they've done. Now, Miller, not known for his three-point shooting. I remember him as a freshman. He, I thought, had tremendous upside. He had range, liked to shoot from outside, had some injuries throughout his career, but looks like he's now kind of rounding into form, and he and Green give them a really nice post presence.
Blue Hens down 26-17, under 9 left here in the first half. Verretto with the rock, top of the key, skips it over to Bryant, left wing, now feeds it down low to Carter. Working near the left block, spins, dribbles, needs help. He's double-teamed and trapped underneath the hoop. He's spinning, pivoting, and he finds Bryant, 5 on the shot clock. Horton crosses over. He loses the handle, spins around, floats it, but Carter's there with the tip back.
Carter did a great job of recognizing where that shot was going to be missed to. He moved across the lane, rebounded outside his area, and tipped it in with a massive wide right hand to give him extra control. A terrific offensive rebounding play.
Blue Hens down 26-19. Approaching the 8-minute mark here in the first. Pasicha has been on fire for the Huskies. He dribbles right near baseline, now getting some double team, swings it out to the right wing where he gives it to Miller. Pasicha gets a pick from Miller. He misses on the three attempt, rebounded by Bryant, who sprints up the court left to right. Ball fake, now finds his teammate in Allen, left wing, dribbles in between his legs, skips it to Carter, working on the left block, being defended by Miller. Swings it back out. Allen with it, left wing, 15 on the shot clock. He dribbles towards baseline, tries to go with the hook shot. It's blocked. Northeastern has it.
Well, Ryan Allen got caught up in the air there and didn't really have much he could do there, and the ball was thrown away. But Northeastern playing much too fast with their son Jason Strong, and a nice play by Darian Bryant to sink to the ball level and make a steal.
Redshirt freshman with the steal. Verretto, left wing, 3, buries it. Matt Verretto from downtown.
What an outstanding play by Darian Bryant. Got the steal because he was positioned perfectly, sprints it up the court, and then gives it to Verretto, who really worked hard in warm-ups from exactly that spot. In rhythm, drives that three down. A nice play by the freshman.
Blue Hens back within 4, under 7 to play here in the first half. Gresham dribble drives off the right block, but he's fouled, and it will be charged to Allen to the dismay of his teammates. They thought he got more ball than body.
Well, that was Clarence Armstrong, the veteran official from this area. Played at Drexel, grew up in Chichester, and wonderful officials, really.
Portion of this broadcast is presented by First Aid Orthopedics, the team of top docs taking care of Delaware on the beach, the bridge, and beyond. Visit firstaidortho.com. Play will resume, but it will be a free throw attempt here for Northeastern's Danelle Gresham. First free throw attempt of the game comes under 7 minutes here in the first half. Gresham, an 84% free throw shooter, sinks the first, but Bill, you've been intrigued by the way Northeastern has been guarding Eric Carter tonight.
They've done a nice job. Both Green and Miller have tried to drive Eric off his spot, but Eric's done a nice job of combating them down there. What they're doing typically is digging on his first dribble. So what Eric might want to do is space post up so he can see how the defense is coming at him and then skip the ball or attack immediately before the defender can recover.
Gresham missed the back end of the free throw attempt, so Delaware down by five, 27-22. Left wing three from Horton misses short of the rim, rebounded by Pushitsa, who sprints it up, skips it over to Brace, who finger rolls it off the window for an easy bucket.
Well, that was a shot I think that Delaware would probably like to have back just a little early in the shot clock and well defended, and that results in a quick burst out by Pushitsa with Brace running the left wing and a nice underhand scoop shot to score.
Johnson with it, off the right block, needs help. Ball goes on top of the key now, down low to Carter, left elbow, 10 on the shot clock for Carter. He passes it to Johnson, dribbles left, finds Verretto who hit a three. Now Bryant, top of the key, stutter steps, pulls up deep two, misses off the rim, and it's barely grazed the rim, goes out of bounds. It'll be Huskies basketball.
Northeastern really extends their defense. They get out and chase people off of the three-point line. That's one of the keys and tenets to their very sophisticated defensive approach. But Delaware then needs to keep driving the ball. They've had some success doing that, get some transition looks, and also continue to work the ball into Eric Carter. He did face up the last time, and that resulted in the defense not being able to double-team him.
Offensive foul called against Northeastern's Danelle Gresham. His first, team's third for the Huskies, so Delaware gets a break down by seven. Just under six to play here in the first half.
Northeastern does a very good job of off-the-ball screening. They set flares, they set pin downs, et cetera, as well as the pick and roll. That time, Gresham just moving a little too aggressively to set up that screen on the weak side.
Pause in the action. Huskies huddled up. Looks like they may have called a timeout. I did not see the signal yet from the referee as Bill Cohen has gathered his troops. So a timeout has been called apparently, or no, the net has come undone on the far side of the court. So we're going to have a delay here. And those tuning in online, you can see the part of the yarn there of the net came off the hoop of the rim where it connects. So somebody will have to go on a ladder and reconnect the hoop. And won't be me, Bill. I'm not a fan of heights.
Me either. Danny Neeson, who does a great job as the game manager here in the facilities, along with Joe Shirley, immediately get their crew out to get that thing straightened out. Delaware really does a wonderful job of preparing this arena for all the different events they have, and it's a real credit to the organization and the individuals that do such a fine job. We're always well taken care of and comfortable here in the wonderful arena.
Solid crowd on hand here inside the Bobbin, talking about the upgrades and everybody taking care of the arena. This new video scoreboard is a thing of beauty. It's my fourth time here calling a game, and it's hard not to just look up in awe and just realize what an upgrade it was from the old video board. So, of course, kudos to the entire athletic department here at the University of Delaware, Chrissy Raywalk and company, doing an outstanding job, as always, here in Newark, Delaware, as they mend the net here. Let's get you some quick stats. Ithiel Horton leading all scorers for the Blue Hens and Huskies. 11 points for the freshman, 4-7 from the floor, 3 buckets from downtown. And adding to the scoring as well, Eric Carter with 4. Matt Verretto has a 3. Colin Goss and Darian Bryant has 2. For Northeastern, it is the Vasa Pushitsa show. 10 points, 4 of 6 from the field, 2 of 4 from downtown. And then you have Brace with 7, Roland with 5, and Miller and Franklin with 3. That is your box score stat update here as we will resume play after the net is restrung. properly. Delaware's basketball moving left to right on your dial, down by 7, 5:39 and ticking here until halftime.
Gresham still on Ryan Allen. I'm looking forward to watching Ryan Allen work off the ball. He's really good at reading, screening action, and then driving the ball.
Barreto with it, right wing, skips it over to Johnson, who has been shooting hot as of late, feeds it to Bryant, 8 on the shot clock, left elbow, jumper good by Ryan Allen on cue.
Absolutely. He did a wonderful job of reading the pin-down screen on the right side. He curled it. Gresham got caught up on the screen, rises right up into that mid-range shot. Excellent offensive reading by Ryan Allen, who's really improved his game.
Pasicha with it, top of the key, being guarded by Carter. Now it's an over-the-head pass across court, right wing. 3 taken by Gresham. Not a good-looking shot. Comes up short, rebounded by Delaware.
Eric Carter doing a nice job at defending the defensive glass for a shot that was missed so badly.
Wide open 3 from Verretto, a little too strong. Right corner, rebounded by Gresham. He pushes it up the court, dribbles left, now finds Brace, and he will take it left wing. Dribbles left, being guarded by Carter. Chest pass over to Roland. Roland in between his legs, now finds Brace again. Corner, right in front of us, near side, and a foul called against Delaware.
A lot of contact inside. Matty Verretto was caught on Big Green, who's 16. Matty gives a couple inches up, but boy, no fight up to him. He battles inside. He works very hard using his quickness against Green, but he just got trapped on the wrong side and got a foul from behind. Probably a good call because Green had really worked hard for inside and low block position.
Verretto's first, team's 5th for Delaware. Ithiel Horton checks back in for the Blue Hens. Franklin coming back in for Northeastern. Delaware down by 5. 29-24 the score. Ball movement on the top of the perimeter for Northeastern, and is rolling a little Euro step, and he's able to lay it in left hand.
Boy, Roland has a great first step to get by Matty Verretto, and then used his left hand softly off the glass. A really nice play there by the redshirt junior.
Blue Hens down by 7. Carter dribble drive, but the basket does not count. Foul called. And it looks like it was against Northeastern's Anthony Green, his second personal, team's 4th.
Nice changeup there by Eric Carter driving the ball. He usually is backing down and can't see the basket, but now he's facing up a little bit more, which is what I like. A nice changeup there. Billy Phillips doing a great job of coaching.
...31-24 as these two teams look to maintain their positioning in the seeding for the conference tournament. Right now, Northeastern in 2nd place in the conference. Delaware tied for 4th. Blue Hens will get the ball underneath their own hoop. Allen triggers it baseline, gives it to Horton, right wing. Now feeds it top of the key to Ryan Johnson. Johnson swings it back out to Allen, who skips it down, left block to Carter. Ball fake. Being guarded by a pair of Huskies. Now he's backing down his defender in Janelle Gresham, and the bucket made by Carter on a good move.
That time, Eric Carter created some space. Rowland tried to dig in but couldn't get there, and then a turnaround bank shot using his face-up ability here and shooting that mid-range shot to his advantage.
Blue Hens down 31-26, 3.5 and ticking here in the first half. Pasicha with it, asks for a pick, now coasts around the perimeter left wing. Chest passes it over to Jordan Rowland. Now gives it back to Pasicha, who gets a step back three, misses short, gets his own rebound. Brace gets it right wing, head fake. Now ball movement around left wing. Pasicha with this stutter steps, being guarded by Carter. Spin around jumper too hard, off the glass, rebounded by Horton.
Well, Eric Carter got caught in a switch on Pasicha. Two possessions in a row, did a really nice job of defending the very clever ball handler and score.
Verretto misses a wide open three, right wing. Ball's loose underneath the hoop. Northeastern gets it though. Delaware still down by five, under 2:45 left until halftime. Floater finds the shooter's touch by Jordan Rowland, hit the back of the rim, front of the rim, and then found the bottom of the net.
You described it perfectly, a floater, but mostly when a right-hander drives down the lane, he shoots it with his right hand. He shot that floater with his left hand, a very clever play by Rowland.
Horton swings it out to Allen, left wing, near the three-point line, feeds it down low to Carter. Carter finds Verretto, spots up right wing, three, misses wide right. Rebounded by Rowland.
Good look there by Matt Verretto. That's a shot that Coach Inglesby wants him to take. A nice pass out of the post by Eric Carter to a wide-open Verretto. He'll make that shot.
Wide-open three now taken by Miller. It rattles in and around the rim. Rebounded by Verretto, who's a little angry with himself on that missed three. Grabs the rebound emphatically. Gives it to his teammate Allen, who dribbles from the point. Goes left block, and an offensive foul called against Delaware.
Well, Ryan Allen did the right thing. He was driving hard down the lane with his left hand, just bumped the defender with his right shoulder. I think that's a play-on call there. Jeff Clark, the referee, makes the call from behind. I think if you look at this on tape, Ryan Allen's just doing a good job, and the defense is moving in the same plane as him, a little bit of contact. But unfortunately, the foul against Ryan Allen.
Allen not happy, his second personal, and the team six. Under 2 minutes left here in the first half. Deep three taken by Jordan Rowland. He is fouled on the attempt, so he will go to the line for three. But that was in another zip code almost for Rowland.
Torian Jones did a great job with the scouting report, and one of the little subtleties of Rowland's game is that on threes he tends to kick his leg, a la Kobe Bryant, and sometimes he picks up a cheap foul that time. Ithiel was crowding him, but that was one of those where you just got to give him a little bit more space so he doesn't pick up that foul.
Rowland, a three-point shooter for Northeastern, has sunk both of his first two shots. He does get one more, an 89% free throw shooter, but Rowland has multiple three-point shots made in 22 games this year. He's connected on five or more from downtown in five different games this season, so certainly a sharp shooter from beyond the arc. He makes all three, and it swells the Huskies' lead to its largest of the night, 10-point lead for Northeastern. A minute 30 left, and a whistle blown.
Little screening action down there, little for big. Ithiel Horton setting a screen for Eric Carter. They were hoping for a switch, but that time Miller tried to fight through the screen and got the foul. So a nice call there by Martin Inglesby to get not only a foul, but also to get Northeastern's defense a little off key.
Lob pass, baseline from Allen. It goes to Carter. Now Allen able to circle around, top of the key. Give and go to Carter. He's fouled as he was met by, it looked like, Brace, and he got the brunt of it, grimacing a little bit and stretching out his jaw. But Carter foul, he'll go to the line.
That was a single double for Ryan Allen, who reads the screen perfectly, drags the defense right to left, and then drops the ball back over quickly over his right shoulder to Eric Carter rolling down. And Pusica had nothing he could do other than just get in the way of the big man as he rolled to the basket. Would have scored. So a really nice play by Ryan Allen, who continues to impress me with his very fine distribution skills.
Carter, 73% shooter from the stripe, sinks his first, leads the team with 16.2 points per game. Drills the second free throw. Delaware within eight with a minute 17 ticking here until halftime.
Set play being called here by Vasa Pusica. A pull on the shirt. This is a set play where they do some screening action and then a high ball screen for him.
Pusica, right wing, gives it off to Roland. Roland gives it back to Persicha. 10 on the shot clock, a minute on the game ticker, and a foul is called by the official, and it looks like it was against Ithiel Horton. His second, team seventh, and Delaware's bench did not like it.
That's Nick Heater with the call. His father is a big-time ACC official. Heater, one of the young, very fine officials. Got Ithiel Horton just reaching in with both hands on Pusica as he was driving.
Pusica misses the front end of the 1-1. Here's the top of the three from Ryan Allen, and he drains it 36-31. Back in it for the Blue Hens.
Excellent screening action by Eric Carter. A big screen pinned down in the lane. Ryan Allen did a great job of reading it, curling left to right, rising right up in his shot before Gresham, the very fine Northeastern defender, could recover.
And a foul now charged to Darian Bryant, his second personal. Looked like Delaware and the fans thought maybe more of a flop there by Brace, but nonetheless, Bolden Brace will go to the line. The 6'6 junior out of Santa Barbara, California, shooting 78% from the line, and he sinks the front end of the 1-1, so he'll get a second.
This is one of the better free throw shooting teams in the conference, 76% on the year. It's very solid. You win a lot of games with that, and they do it with a lot of players. The only player that's not a particularly good free throw shooter would be Anthony Green, the big man.
Delaware down by 7, 38-31, 35 seconds, and counting off the game clock. Allen with it. He hit a straightaway three. Gives it to Bryant, left wing, being guarded by Pusica. Gets a pick from Carter, dribbles around it right side. Now the ball goes back top of the key to Allen, who stutter steps back now, dribbles right, gets some separation, finds Carter left elbow, loses control near baseline. Three on the shot clock. Carter weaves his way with the scoop under, and he lays it in.
Tremendous footwork by Eric Carter and great patience not to rush himself.
D3 taken by Pusica, misses everything. Clock expires, and Delaware will end the first half with the final bucket, and they will go into the break down by 5, 38-33. Bill.
That was a great finish by Delaware, both at
say, can you see 2 million bucks?
Lotto America is the new drawing game that's sweeping the nation. Get 6 numbers right, including the star ball, and you win. And with jackpots starting at $2 million, you win big. Lotto America from the Delaware Lottery. It's the new way to play and win the American dream.
Here's your Buick, sir.
Actually, that's my Buick.
Your Buick doesn't have a roof rack. This is my Buick.
How are we gonna fit in your mom's Buick?
Easy.
I like that new Buick.
Me too.
I was actually talking about that Buick.
I knew that.
Did you?
Buick's fresh new lineup is full of surprises. Get great deals on our expectation-shattering lineup. Pay no interest for 72 months on most Buick models.
The rule of three states, things that come in threes are inherently more appealing than those that don't. We couldn't agree more. Three SUVs, one GMC. Step up to GMC with up to 19% below MSRP on these select models in stock the longest when you finance through GM Financial.
The month of March is not for the weak. If you want to get to the big dance, the road starts here. Every practice, every game leads to this moment. Win or go home. The CAA tournament is coming to Charleston March 9th through 12th. 10 teams, one goal, to be crowned champion. Go to CAASports.com for more information.
players come back and start playing for the university. And as far as my best shot and best move, apparently not enough of them.
I don't know about that.
I remember after one game we were practicing and Coach Wisniewski came up to me and said, Peter, I think your best shot's the layup.
and Wiz knew how to do it, didn't he?
Oh, he did.
But you guys had won over 66% of your games here in Delaware and had 25 rebounds against John Hopkins in your career. Pete, it's an absolute honor and a pleasure to have you with us. Thanks so much for spending some time, and we hope to see you more and stay in great health.
Thanks for inviting me. I enjoyed it.
Great fun, Pete. Thank you.
That's Pete Cloud, former Delaware basketball player, class of 64, joining us here on 94.7 WDSD. Let's get you some stats of the first half. Delaware trailing Northeastern 38-33. And your leading scorer of the game is Jordan Rowland for Northeastern. He has 12 points, a perfect 4 of 4 from the floor. He has made a 3 and has connected on all 3 free throws. Vasa Pushica right behind him at 10. Bolden Brace at 9. And then you have Jeremy Miller and Miles Franklin at 3 apiece. For the Delaware Blue Hens, leading the way is Ithiel Horton. He had 27 up in Boston earlier this year, Bill. He's doing everything he can. Eric Carter with 10 points already, 4 rebounds shy of another double-double for the redshirt senior. Ryan Allen has 5 points. Matt Verretta with 3. Colin Goss with 2. Rebounding, Delaware slightly out-rebounding Northeastern, 13-11, 11 defensive rebounds to Northeastern's 10, 2 on the offensive glass for Delaware to the Huskies, 1. 8 assists for the Huskies, 6 for Delaware, 5 turnovers for the Blue Hens, 4 cough-ups for Northeastern. It's been a pretty much back-and-forth game, Bill. Northeastern has had a lead up to 10, but Delaware sticking around.
They certainly have. It's been with their defense. They've done a really nice job in the second half of the first half of defending the three. They've really been engaged. Darian Bryant, Ithiel Horton, Ryan Allen doing a great job. Love to see us get to the foul line a little bit more. One of the assets that Northeastern brings, they defend the three and they play pretty good defense without fouling. Delaware's done a great job on the defensive glass. Only one offensive rebound for Northeastern. We need to extend and make sure that three is defended well the whole second half. We've probably got to have a little better answer for Jordan Rowland, who's really played well for Northeastern. Pusica is going to get his points because he handles the ball a lot. He's going to take volume shooting, but we can't let Rowland get above his scoring average. We've done a nice job on Gresham and their bigs inside. Now we just need to make sure we lock down those guys. But I really like the way Delaware competed in the last 3 minutes of the half.
Eric Carter closed out that first half with a very acrobatic scoop and score there by the forward, and he will look to try and get his team out in front. Delaware down 38-33 as we are awaiting the second half of action here in the CAA battle. Northeastern looking to split the season series at one game apiece. Delaware looking for the sweep to stop a miniature two-game losing streak. Both teams trending in different directions. Bill, Delaware losing 5 of their last 7, but 4 of them by 8 points or less, so they've been in most of those games. Meanwhile, Northeastern has won 11 of its last 13, playing arguably its best basketball of the season. Delaware starts with the basketball, moving right to left on the dial. Carter with it off the right block, trying to back down his defender, Green. He needs some help. He finds Horton, far corner, 3, buries it, and a good start for the Blue Hens here in the second half.
Well, Eric Carter did a great job of resecuring the ball. It was knocked away after they dug on the first dribble by Rowland, but he got it back, got it to Horton. A really fine shot by the freshman, who looks to me to be unbelievably confident in rhythm.
Delaware back within a bucket, down by 2, just underway here in the second half. Pasicha with it, skips it over to Brace. Ball fake, dribbles baseline, spins, needs some help, gives it back to Pasicha. 5 on the shot clock already for the Huskies. He's on the left wing, I don't think he noticed it. Steps back, hot arcing shot, not even close. Air ball, shot clock violation. Couldn't draw up a better start here in the second half for Delaware, Bill.
A great job with Horton hitting the three and then going down, going to open the second half with 2-3 zone. Great job sliding, cutting off the drive by Brace and forcing Pushica to take a very, very high, a low probability shot.
Lou Hens looking to tie the game up or take the lead with a three. Allen with it, dribbles right, finds Carter near the right elbow. He pivots, spins, pullback jumper, misses short, but it was a good look by Carter.
I love the move, spinning back, something he's been working on hard in practice, just backed up a little bit too much, but he had good space there against Anthony Green.
Gresham try to cross up Allen, gives it over to Roland, who misses with a left wing three, too tough off the back of the rim, rebounded by Bryant.
Northeastern loves that dribble handoff on the weak side. Delaware's got to be sure they jam that up and make sure the shooter can't step back behind the exchange.
Horton with it, top of the key, gives it to Bryant. Bryant calling for Allen to go towards the hoop. Set play, gives it to Carter. Carter off the left block, 15-footer, now spins around, gets a little closer, dribbles with his right, five on the shot clock, being guarded by Green. Backing him down, right hook shot misses, but Green comes down with a rebound.
Excellent individual defense by Anthony Green. Eric Carter possessed the ball for an awfully long time, and then Brace down at the other end. They push the ball so quickly and get a three in transition. That's another one of the keys to the game. Do not let Northeastern get any easy baskets running the ball down after a miss.
That was easy for Bolden Brace, who is shooting 40% from downtown. He had all the time in the world to set his shot up, and he drained it. Delaware down by five, 41-36, 17 and a half to go in the game. Horton gives it to Carter, who's top of the key. Beautiful skip pass. Bryant too hard. He gets his own rebound, goes left side. He's fouled, misses, but will at least go to the line.
We talked about how Northeastern is tenacious in guarding the three-point line. One of the things you can do against that kind of denial defense and pressed-out defense is backdoor. Darian Bryant executed it perfectly. A wonderful bounce pass by Eric Carter to a driving Bryant who just missed the shot but stayed with it because his release was right at the rim. He came down and went back up and got his own rebound.
Bryant to the line, a 57% shooter from the stripe. High-arcing shot is good. And, Bill, we talked about it prior to tonight's broadcast, but there was a fantastic feature with Darian Bryant and his mother, Joanne, who attends almost every game for Bryant. It was about Bryant's mother telling Darian to embrace life no matter what challenges may come in front of you. And the article was on Delaware team website. It was about his mother suffering from breast cancer, stage three, fighting it, being a warrior. And Darian Bryant said that she is without a doubt his role model. Great read.
Absolutely. That's a great comment by you, and I'm sorry I haven't had a chance to read it myself, but Darian Bryant is everything you just described, a tenacious defender but a wonderful competitor.
Bryant with the contested shot there off the stroke of Donnell Gresham forces the miss. Horton with the basketball gives it to Johnson, who feeds it down low to Carter, who missed the handle, gives it to Bryant, swings it out to Horton. Toilet bowls in and out of the rim. Good look, though, by the freshman. Pasicha with the left wing three, bottom of the net, can't leave him open.
You cannot, but you've got to make sure you sprint back on defense, locate their shooters, and they have three on the floor at range. Brace delivers a nice pass to Pasicha, who was in rhythm on the left side.
Delaware down 44-38. Carter ball fake, gets a little closer, fights through two defenders, and gets the roll in straight away.
Some contact inside. They waved it off, but Eric Carter did a great job of concentrating on finishing over the front of the rim. Excellent catch and finish through contact.
Inglesby thought it was a foul. Northeastern with it, moving left to right. Delaware down by four, under 16 to go here. Gresham with it, dribbles right, lost his balance, now goes to the right wing. Pasicha dribble, drives right over the high swat of Carter. Pretty shot high off the glass.
Pasicha was able to drive through the gap on the right side between the top man and the bottom man of the 2-3 zone. Eric Carter was forced to rotate, but Pasicha had the right counter to that with a little bit of teardrop floater.
Johnson with the pretty feed down low to Bryant. Easy bucket for Darian. And Delaware back within four, 46-42 the score.
By driving the ball down the lane, you force the help to rotate or help up, and they did that. The drop-off pass to Darian Bryant scoring around the rim.
Pasicha with it, gives it to Gresham. Give and go back to the top of the key with Pasicha. Getting it, dribbles right, feeds Green down low, being guarded by Carter, and he's stripped away and is into the hands of Johnson.
Green brought the ball down low, and Eric Carter had his hands right there to knock it away. An excellent low post defense.
Allen with it, dribbles right, try to find Carter. Errant pass, nobody was home. Gresham picks it up for Northeastern, feeds it to Brace, another bucket in transition.
Well, we did a good job for the most part in the first half of defending their sprint actions and their transition actions. Now they're seeming to get out a little bit quicker, and that's something I'm sure Billy Cohen tried to emphasize at halftime. Delaware's counter is get back on defense, sprint back, or don't have those turnovers that result in quick runouts.
Allen left elbow jumper, buries it, bottom of the net. Good-looking shot there by Allen, who has 7 points.
He caught Gresham again, getting pinned on a screen as he curled on a nice read by Ryan Allen.
Brace with it, hop steps, feeds it down low where Anthony Green is fouled underneath the hoop, and he will go to the line after a media timeout. Delaware down 48-44. We'll take the break with them. Don't go anywhere. 94.7 WDSD. The game, XL Business Systems, and the official business system partner of the Delaware Blue Hens Radio and iHeartRadio Delaware. And, Bill, you really like that foul from Eric Carter to Anthony Green.
Well, Anthony Green is not a particularly good free throw shooter on a team that has superb free throw shooters. So any time you get Green, it looks like he's going to dunk it or lay it in. You might as well foul him on the ground. Maybe you'll get lucky and strip it away. But worst case is he goes to the line and he shoots it at 58% and a smart percentage defensive play.
Green to the line so far tonight. Does not have a point. Does have 3 rebounds and assist. And the first shot rattles around the rim and misses.
Well, you can see why he doesn't shoot it as well as his teammates from a percentage standpoint. A very flat release for a big man. You need to get about 45 degrees of arc. The ball coming down, descending with backspin.
Green misses the second. A loud applause. Believe there's a giveaway for any Northeastern Husky that misses 2 straight free throws. So it was a big part of the game, obviously, but a little bit louder than most times here at the Bob for back-to-back missed free throws. Blue Hens have it right to left on the dial, down by 4, approaching the 14-minute mark. Top of the key was Colin Goss. Thought about a 3, decided otherwise, gives it to Allen, who misses short. Right wing 3 attempt, and it's rebounded by Brace, who brings it up left right.
Colin Goss has come in with a lot of energy playing at that stretch 4 position at the top of the key.
Roland weaves his way in and out of some traffic, lays it up right hand for the Huskies. Delaware back down by 6.
They lifted the defense. Colin Goss was not available at the rim. Roland with a nice little jump stop, back going back left to right to score.
Horton drives to the rim, gives it to his teammate in Jacob Cushing, and he drives it off the left block with an acrobatic right-handed layup.
The junior from Naperville, Illinois, has been playing extremely well here in the late conference play. An excellent three-point shooter, but I love it when he drives the ball. He can finish at the rim. He's very athletic.
Green with it off the right block. Right hook shot too hard. Swivels in and out of the rim. Here comes Delaware with Allen pushing it up the court. Finds Goss underneath the hoop. A little too far was he led, so they reset things on top of the key. Delaware down by 4, 50-46. Allen driving, but he loses his footing. Had some lane separation left side, but it will be called for the travel. Tough break for Allen in Delaware.
It certainly was, because he had Anthony Green on a switch and was going to be able to attack the big man's body. He just lost his balance there. It wasn't because anything he did. It looked like there was some moisture on the floor. A smart play. Colin Goss doing a great job of sprinting rim to rim. Received that pass from Ryan Allen. Couldn't quite score, but I love the activity level of Colin Goss, giving us some great minutes here tonight.
Huskies have it. Miles Franklin, the sophomore, back in for the Huskies. He has it, skips it out. Top of the key to Jeremy Miller. Ball goes to Pasicha, right corner, dribbles left. He gets a pick against Bryant, misses a three attempt, too far left of the rim. Horton with the board.
He stepped back behind the screen, but Darian Bryant did a great job of immediately closing out with the high hand.
Horton dribble driving to the left. Shot won't count. He made it, but a foul called on the floor. And it looks like it was against number 12, Jordan Rowland, his second, team second of the second half.
Theo Horton's done a nice job here with versatility to his game. We know he can shoot the three from the spot, but now he's starting to drive the ball, which is strategically what Delaware's wanted to do against this defense.
Allen, pull-up jumper, left elbow, swishes it. Blue Hens within two.
Big-time shot by Allen, rising up over Miller's 6'10", outstretched arm. A wonderful high release with Ryan Allen's shot.
Franklin with the ball, right wing for the Huskies. Gives it to Brace, who tried to dribble drive baseline. Pasicha with it, left wing, fakes a three. Bryant didn't move. 10 on the shot clock. The fans getting loud here inside the Bob. Pasicha gives it to Franklin. A foul called and a charge taken. And it looked like Ryan Allen taking the charge from Vasa Pasicha.
What a smart play by Ryan Allen. You know you can draw charges on drivers, but what I love, the heady defenders are looking to draw charges sometimes on passers who are out of control and not sliding to the side. Ryan Allen with an outstanding defensive play after a great shot at the other end.
Fans join Scott Klatskin and Matt Janis for the next Blue Hens basketball coach. This show presented by First Aid Orthopedics, live from Klondike Kate's on Main Street. Next basketball show will be next Monday, and that will be almost the turn of the calendar, March 4th from 7 to 8 p.m. And remember, receive 20% off Klondike Kate's every Sunday when you wear blue and gold from 4 to 9 p.m. Delaware down 50 to 48, but Bill, the Blue Hens playing with a little bit more physicality. They're able to defend the three-point line. Northeastern got off to a fantastic start. At one point, they were 4 of 6 to start. Since they're 8 of 20 from downtown. What does Delaware need to do to make some tweaks and adjustments to try and come out of this game with a victory?
Keep doing what they're doing defensively. They're really connected. They're communicating. They're playing to the game plan. Torian Jones has done a great job of getting them prepared here in these last 3 days. And offensively, we've really found a nice connection here with Horton, Allen, and Eric Carter, all providing different ways to score. Ryan Allen now really seems engaged to me. What I liked was when he wasn't starting out shooting as well or scoring, he was still working extremely hard defensively. And as always, he is just such a difficult guard because he moves so well without the ball.
Delaware getting back into the game. Northeastern has led by as many as 10 tonight. The Blue Hens had a lead earlier in the game, but not for long. It was back in the first half, and it was just a two-point advantage. Last lead was back at that same point in the game, and it was 8-6 Delaware, 15-37. And Delaware has been fighting its way, scratching and clawing to get back, and that's exactly what they've been doing. Down by two with the basketball, looking to tie or take the second lead of the game.
Pusica was really working over the official, Clark, to find out why that foul was called. He thought he slid to the side, but Clark made the right call. A heady play by Ryan Allen.
Bryant with it near the right elbow. Backing down Pasicha. Good pivot off of his foot. Too hard, though, off the shot. Goss tipped it. Couldn't get it. Rebounded by Rowland for Northeastern.
Great footwork inside by Darian Bryant. Just missed the shot at the rim. I love the fact Delaware is attacking the glass, attacking the rim, trying to get good scoring opportunities.
Franklin feeds it to Brace, who's working on the right block. Now Franklin gets it left wing baseline. Brace back with it left wing beyond the three-point line. Under 10 to shoot for the Huskies. Brace loses it, and there's Ryan Allen to pick up the basketball.
Terrific individual defense by Jacob Cushing on Brace at the other end. A wide-open shot. Good offense there by Delaware, but what they're doing is Corey, they're really working hard, and they're energized defensively.
Goss missed the three, but head coach Martin Inglesby liked the shot taken. Delaware still down by two, under 11 to play here in the game. Ball in the hands of Roland, being guarded by Horton, who gets picked. Now Goss picks him up. Feed down low to Miller. He misses everything off the lay-in. Goss with the rebound. Here comes Allen right to left on the dial.
Miller had a great position inside, but Ryan Allen stood tall, went high hands up, and forced Miller to take a shot well over the rim from the weak side. An excellent job rotating by Ryan Allen.
Allen with it. Almost double-teamed by the Huskies. They switch off in their man-to-man defense. Allen weaves through the defense, gives it to Horton, right corner three, misses short. Rebounded by Jeremy Miller, and here comes Northeastern. Pasicha with it, puts on the brakes right on front of the right wing, trying to get positioning against Cushing. He can't get the lefty lay-in as it teetered on the rim. Rebounded by Delaware. Allen finds Horton, spots it up for a three, misses off the heel of the rim. Here comes the Huskies. Brace gives it over to Roland. Roland, a floater with the left hand, misses. Rebounded by Cushing, and now Delaware will slow things down.
That's that left-hand floater that he made early in the game. I don't believe it's a high percentage shot, but that is just great action end-to-end by both teams here. Delaware doing a great job defensively of sprinting back and being able to rebound that miss.
The fans on their feet here inside the Bob. 9:31 left to play as head coach Martin Inglesby takes a timeout. We will stay inside the Bob, but boy, what a sequence there, as you mentioned, from Delaware.
Here's the difference right now. Delaware is getting better quality shots in Northeastern. They just haven't made some good looks. And that's all you can ask for as a coach. You can run your offense or your transition game. And if you get wide open shots, you've got to live with that. We're at the other end. Northeastern is really having trouble now getting disconnected from Delaware's locked-in defense. They've really done a nice job of contesting shots, doing a good job with their screening action. So Delaware's defense has really sharpened up. Martin Inglesby's got to be very proud about that effort. But at the other end, they can't be discouraged. They've had terrific looks the last four shots. If they keep getting those, they're going to make them. If they keep defending, they're going to be able to whittle into this final two-point lead and take control of this game.
The Blue Hens defense holding the Huskies in a scoring drought over 4 minutes now, thanks to that fantastic transition defense by the Blue Hens. 50-48, Blue Hens trail. If you're just joining us, both teams right now in the top four of the conference for CAA tournament seeding. Northeastern right now second at 12-4 in conference play. Delaware tied for fourth, 8-8 in CAA play. The top six get a bye, so that's what these teams are striving for. Delaware, though, the only team to beat the Huskies in Boston this year. How good were the Huskies in Matthews Arena? They finished out their home slate on a seven-game winning streak. Overall went 11-2. However, much different team on the road, just 6-6. You get them on the ropes, there's an ability and a chance to win the game. And Delaware, who in their own right play very well in front of their home crowd, looking to do just that.
Boy, they certainly are. And I want to make an extra point about that win up at Northeastern. Delaware just had a tough time two nights before at Hofstra and then found a way to rally. That was just a great program win by Martin Inglesby's team to find a way to beat a terrific team on the road after a tough game. So great job by Delaware, and that just shows the character of this team.
Carter with the ball for the Blue Hens, gives it to Horton, left elbow, skips it over to Carter. A little bit of a dangerous pass by the freshman, but the redshirt senior able to clean it up. Five on the shot clock. Carter scoops and can't get it. He doesn't get the rim. It hits high off the glass. Ball goes out of bounds. It will be 1 second left for Delaware, so really a tough situation here for the Blue Hens.
Eric Carter unfortunately lost his dribble and couldn't get one of his teammates to come over and get the ball from him. Just kind of stepped through Miller, and that's what created the miss. They'll just throw it over the top here and try for a three.
Bryant baseline trigger. Carter with the three. He hits it, but they're going to look at the monitor. It was close. 13th-year head coach Bill Cohen of Northeastern waving his arms up saying no, and they're going to take a look.
Boy, I would have thought that was good. This is going to be a very interesting look at the replay here because Eric Carter went right up into the shot.
That's going to be close. We do have a monitor here courtside, and it is bang, bang on the replay. Bryant triggered it in underneath Delaware's own hoop. Carter received it on the far right wing and connected on the three. That would be just his third three-pointer of the season. So obviously Carter not really expected to make the three. We got another look, catch and shoot, and they say no. It's a shot clock violation. So a tough break for Delaware as the redshirt senior almost came up with a go-ahead basket.
Boy, a really smart play by Eric Carter, knowing that his big probably wouldn't push out on him. He gets located at the three, just like we were talking about, rises up into the shot. That thing felt like it was the shortest second in history.
So it takes a little bit of the excitement out of the Bob Carpenter Center for the time being. Northeastern with the ball. Pusicha with it, gives it to Green, who's on the right wing. Give and go back to the point guard from Serbia. He finds Brace. He dribble drive, now gives it to Green, and he dunks over Carter, and a foul called against Eric Carter. So it'll be a three-point play coming for Anthony Green.
Brace was able to dribble into the lane coming from left to right and then did a great job of getting both defenders up in the air and dropping the ball off to Anthony Green, who with that big body just was able to rise up and dunk it over Eric Carter. That's one where on the dunk, Eric might want to step away and just let him finish it, because very difficult to block that or not allow it to go in.
Green completes the three-point play. Talking about a big body, 6'10", 252-pounder, a center from Quincy, Massachusetts, leads the team with 25 blocks on the season. Delaware with it, down 53-48. Horton with it, dribbles left side. Cushing spots up for three, misses short left of the rim. Rebounded by Brace.
Another good look by Delaware on a little dribble handoff and then weak side exchange play. Could have easily gone in.
Roland feeds it to Green. Back-to-back slams by the big center, both of the two-handed variety.
Well, unfortunately, Delaware did not get an opportunity to rotate down on the backside. Green's free there. The drop-off pass allows him a very easy basket.
Delaware down 55-48, nearing the 8-minute mark to play here in the game. Blue Hens looking to avoid their third straight loss. Three taken by Allen, and he drills it. Contested Trey, and Allen says no problem.
Ryan Allen has a great flair for drama. He knows when his team really needs a big pickup, and that was a huge shot.
Brace finds Persicha wide open for a three. He can't connect. Volleying for it was Green and Brace. Brace gets it, gives it back to Persicha, who finds Gresham right wing, and Northeastern will set things up.
Delaware in the zone, having a little difficulty there, getting their block out assignments, which resulted in the offensive rebound by Brace. A smart play by him to bring it out.
Roland steps back beyond the three-point arc, gives it over to the right wing where Pasicha has it. Cross-court pass, deep three taken by Roland. Too strong off the right of the rim. Easy rebound by the freshman, Ithiel Horton, who paces right to left up the court.
Skip pass there by Pusicha to Roland, who sometimes has a very flat release.
Horton with the three, but it was last touched by the Huskies. So it will be Blue Hens basketball when we come back. 55-51, Delaware trails, just over 7 minutes left in the game on 94.7 WDSD. Pizza from anywhere, even if it's not theirs. You could get rewards points towards free Domino's pizza. Learn more at pointsforpies.com. Blue Hens down by 4, 7:09 left to play here in the ball game. I'm Corey Nido alongside Bill Harmon. Benny Pinella back in our Newcastle studio. And, Bill, this is shaping up to what should be a wire-to-wire finish.
I thought this would go right down to the final seconds. Delaware competing at the defensive end, getting better quality shots at the other end. Just haven't made a few here in this last three-minute stretch. But I love the tempo of the game, really favoring Delaware at the moment.
Bryant with the ball, top of the key, 7 minutes now. And under that mark here, left between these two CAA foes. Horton with it, gives it to Carter, right wing. Now finds Allen. Allen, Sutter steps, looks, floats. He misses the shot, but a foul is called against Northeastern. Looked like it was against Donnell Gresham.
Ryan Allen did a nice job there of slow reading the pick and roll high by Eric Carter, drawing the foul underneath by Gresham.
Gresham second, team's fourth for Northeastern. Right elbow jumper good by Ryan Allen. And that's been a sweet spot tonight, Bill, from the left and right side of the elbow.
Screening action, using it well because he rubs his defender off. Gresham caught behind the screen, has to curl on it. Ryan Allen rolls right up into a shot and scores.
Fans chanting defense, looking for a stop, and they almost got a good defense by Carter, but Anthony Green getting the lay-in to roll around almost the entire rim before falling in for a basket. Delaware down by 4, 57-53.
Green with really nice touch inside, very physical player who's now trying to assert himself against Eric Carter inside.
Harden with it, dribbles left, and lays it off the glass high. He was able to split two defenders nicely.
The ability of Ethio Horton to get deep, but not too deep, where he still has the right angle to use the backboard with his left hand on the left side. A really smart play by the freshman.
The Blue Hens have been competitive throughout this entire season, looking for their first lead since the first half. Down by 2. Here's a left wing three by Northeastern, and it's connected by Donnell Gresham, who's shooting 42% from downtown.
Well, Gresham had been 0-for-3 with some tough looks, but that time Northeastern did a good job of moving the ball inside out against Delaware's 2-3 zone and finding Gresham wide open on the left side.
Ball goes out of bounds. Last touched by Bolden Brace of Northeastern. Horton tried to find Ryan Johnson slicing to the basket. Was a little too strong on the pass, and Delaware was trying to kick it out near side, and luckily, it was touched by a Husky.
Delaware's done a nice job this half of also running their offense at a great speed, cutting hard, setting good screens, really moving without the basketball, making it very difficult for Northeastern to defend them.
8 on the shot clock for Delaware. Deep three, right wing, misses everything from Allen, goes out of bounds. Tough shot, though, for the sophomore, and it will be Northeastern basketball.
He rejected the screen on the right side, kind of rose up into his shot. A pretty good defense there by Gresham, and a good read by Ryan Allen trying to create some space.
Step back three made by Jordan Rowland. Are you kidding me?
Rowland, step back. He likes to step back on the left side where he can create more space. That time he stepped back on the right side, a really difficult footwork movement. One of the great shooters in the game who played for the University of Delaware, John Gordon, had that shot, but not many have it.
Blue Hens now see themselves down by 8, 63-55. Jordan Rowland with the step back three, almost the James Harden-esque, the NBA fans. It's been controversial where Harden looks like he takes almost two steps without dribbling, but Rowland was able to get that separation, and he's their sharpshooter.
Well, Rowland's had an excellent game. He's been driving the ball. He's been locating out on the three-point land. So few players in college basketball can actually create a three-point shot off their own dribble. There are so many standstill shooters today or recipients of a great pass or an overcommit by the defense. But Rowland that time, as you perfectly described, and I did not think it was a walk, did a nice job of stepping back, creating a little bit of space, but really difficult to do on the right side of the court for a right-hander.
Well, fans broadcast on WDSD-FM are powered by Brandywine Electronics. Visit BEL.com for all your audio needs. Blue Hens need a basket, down 63-55, under 5 remaining here in the game. Ball goes to the right wing to Bryant, who feeds it down low to Carter, but it's stolen away mid-air by Anthony Green. Here comes Vasa Pušica from Serbia, left to right on the dial. Now the ball goes to Gresham, who dribbles back near center court. Almost ball gets almost away from Green. He's on top of the key, finds Brace. He gets a good step, but it's blocked by Johnson. He's able to keep it from going out of bounds. Carter gets it. It's swatted away by Donnell Gresham. Out of bounds, it will be Blue Hens basketball. But what an effort by Ryan Johnson.
We talk about all the little things he does to help his team win. That time he trailed it, timed it perfectly to block it with those long arms. His right arms got out and blocked the ball and then saved it back into it. Only a teammate. A wonderful and a big-time defensive play in the clutch.
Carter has it down low, left block, dribbles twice, now picks up his dribble, and a foul is called. And it was against Anthony Green, the 6'10" senior, his third personal, team's fifth. And we will take immediate timeout. 3:57 left to play. Delaware down. Freshman gives it to Bryant. He needs help, and he tries to get it to Allen, and it goes out of bounds right in front of Delaware's bench, far sideline.
Well, Delaware is trying to distribute the ball around, working it from left to right. Jacob Cushing backdoored when he probably should have stepped back out because of the shot clock situation. Just Delaware with not enough time there to get a shot off.
Green with it, gives it to Pochetta, and he drains it. Pochetta again. Said Pochetta like he had. Jeez.
Don't worry about it. Pochetta is really a fine spot-up shooter. He's got to be made to dribble. Delaware's got to get an extra hand in. But Ryan Allen with a fantastic drive down the lane with his left hand, using the backboard to soften it up. Ryan Allen's playing at an extremely high level offensively.
He certainly is. Now has 16 points on the night. Delaware down 66-57, under three remaining here in the game. Delaware looking for the season sweep, an alley-oop attempt, and it's connected. Anthony Green on the slam dunk alley-oop, and he's really been a factor here in the second half.
What a clever pass by Roland, knowing that it was a weak side pick and roll. There was no help there other than Eric Carter recovering late, and that's what created the lob opportunity.
Offensive foul called against Delaware, so tough break for the Blue Hens. Delaware down by 11, 68-57 the score.
Eric Carter was working hard to get position there and unfortunately just used his hands a little too much against the big man Green to draw that turnover, which was an offensive foul.
Just the third team foul for Delaware, under 3 minutes left in the ballgame. Delaware, though, needs some stops and then some buckets. Pochetta with it, calling for a pick from Thomas. He gets it against Bryant. Carter switches over him. Now that ball is tipped. Nice job by Delaware. And it's corralled by Ryan Allen, who feeds it to Horton, dribbling right, tries to get it to Carter, didn't see Gresham, who picks his pass off, gives it to Brace, who lays it in right hand. Allen tried to contest it, and Northeastern now starting to pull away.
There's nothing that Ryan Allen could do there. The turnover created the run out, a really nice pass, and Brace is really good in transition.
Three taken by Carter, and he misses, and it goes out of bounds. Down by 13, a minute 41 to go. And Delaware was within as little as two, Bill, but Northeastern able to pull away with some transition offense and turnovers.
They took advantage of some of Delaware's mistakes. They were able to hit a couple big threes, the one on the step back that you so well described on the right side by Roland, and then Pusica with another one. But transition has really been a factor here in the second half. Delaware's played very hard. They've defended about as well as they can against an excellent offensive team.
A minute 24 to go, 10 on the shot clock. Pusica has it. Delaware does have some fouls to give. Bryant, though, backing up. Now it's Johnson. Pusica drills a three from Rehoboth Beach. That was beyond the arc in another zip code. And Pusica now has 21 points.
Pusica plays at such a nice pace. That was what I call a rhythm three, as he kind of rolled into that. You've just got to be up there and make the shooter feel less comfortable.
Near corner three, drilled by Jacob Cushing, his 18th three of the year. And a timeout taken. Delaware down by 13, under a minute left to play. We'll take another break. When we come back, more basketball, 94.7 WDSD. How do you make that?
He's a really good player.
Yeah.
He's got a beautiful release. It looks the same every time, and he plays at such a wonderful speed. He's a great player for young players to watch. You know, he's never out of control.
So I've never played. Is that just muscle memory with the release?
Absolutely. Yeah. And he's done it. Like you with baseball, how many times you've swung a bat on a curveball? You know, it's the same thing. He's done it probably hundreds of thousands of times in his life. It's exactly what it is muscle memory. But he's got really good mechanics.
How long does Martin usually take after a loss? Long time? All right.
It depends, Corey. But let's keep it really short tonight.
Back inside the Bob Carpenter Center, I'm Corey Nido alongside Bill Harmon. Benny Pinella back in our studio. Delaware trailing by 13 and have a bit of a mountain to climb. 52 seconds left in the game. They were down by as little as two, but Northeastern able to swell the lead in a whistle blown before the trigger pass from Northeastern. And the foul was called against Ryan Allen, his third, team's fourth.
Well, Delaware has a number of fouls to give here before they can get Northeastern into the one-on-one. So they'll look to make a steal, and then they'll foul right away to preserve as much clock as they can.
Full court press by Delaware gets beat by Northeastern. Now Horton hugs Jordan Rowland around the ribs for a foul. That is Horton's third foul, team's fifth.
And Delaware will continue to do this. You go for a steal. You try to get a double team. If you don't get it immediately, you've got a foul. And at this point, you can't worry about who is the fouler. If Ryan Allen has three, he may have to get his fourth here just to stop the clock.
Skip pass to Rowland. And it was Horton, it looked like, who got the foul. So another one charged. It's the sixth. So next one would give Northeastern the 1-1 bonus.
And unfortunately, Northeastern is really good at closing out games because of their free throw shooting, but it's the only hope Delaware has.
Bryant fouls Pusica, so that will send the Serbian native to the line with 43 ticks to go in this game. And, Bill, it's really a tough one for Delaware, looking like it will lose its third in a row. They were in the game from opening tip, but the final 2 minutes or so, Northeastern just really able to distance themselves.
They did with some wonderful three-point shooting and some transition baskets, but I thought when the game mattered, Delaware fought so hard. They got better looks at the basket. They just couldn't make them. in a huge play at 50-48 on that out-of-bounds under where Eric Carter stepped back with a second. He made the shot. It would have put Delaware ahead by one. It almost kind of changed the complexion of the game, and unfortunately they went to the video review, and it ruled that the time had expired. But, boy, that was, as I said, a very quick second.
Pushita misses the second. Connor Rufo with the ball checking in for the first time, and he's able to weave his way in and out and lays it in. The sophomore, nice move.
How about the sophomore from Sanford School who had a bad hamstring the other day and really fought back remarkably well. His parents, terrific supporters of the program, and you need a lot of Connor Rufos around. He just does all the little things in practice. A terrific young man, an excellent student. And a real credit to Stan Waterman's Sanford Warriors program.
Barreto with the foul along with Connor Rufo. You also have Davis Long in the game for Delaware. So Martin Inglesby going to his bench, giving his starters the final 40-some seconds of rest. And Delaware will have to go back to the drawing board and have a quick turnaround. They have a very tough opponent coming up in Hofstra, Bill.
Yes, they do, but they're down. At least they were down up at Drexel, so anybody on the road can be beaten. It'll be important that Delaware regroups quickly tomorrow, and then they have the 4 o'clock Saturday afternoon game, which I fully expect them to come back and give a great vaunted effort.
There's a bucket made by Matt Verretto. Delaware down 75-64. Clock ticking 14 seconds. Don't forget the American Spirit Federal Credit Union postgame show coming up after the conclusion. And Northeastern will just watch the clock wind down. 3-2 ball game and a tough break and game for the Delaware Blue Hens, who ultimately fall tonight by a final score of 75-64. With the loss, Delaware falls to 16-14 on the year overall. And below 500, 8-9 in CAA play. Meanwhile, the Northeastern Huskies, Bill, you mentioned, might be the best team in the conference. We know Hofstra has the better record. College of Charleston's playing well, but overall, the Huskies team very talented, top to bottom, and we saw that as Northeastern improved to 19-10 and now 13-4 in CAA play.
I don't think there's a team that plays at both ends as effectively and efficiently is Northeastern. They're very well coached by Billy Cohen and his assistant staff. A really wonderful story. The gentleman that coached Bill Cohen at Hamilton College, where he was a star, Tommy Murphy, was added to the staff 11 years ago. And Tom has a big role as coordinator of basketball advancement, a terrific guy, very knowledgeable. But I